Hey everyone, Rocco here. I'm here to launch an exciting new segment called 5-Minute Lessons, where we feature our instructors doing what they do best, and that's teaching. Since I play drums myself, I'm gonna kick off the first one on a lesson with drum tuning. Specifically, we're gonna focus on the snare drum and how to get a good sound with minimal effort. So without further ado, let's check it out. Hey again, before we get started, let's go ahead and talk about a few of the elements of the snare drum. So that way, as we progress through this video, it's gonna make a lot more sense and you're gonna get more out of it. So the first element that we're gonna talk about is gonna be these tension rods. They're basically just screws that sit around the top and the bottom of every drum. This one here, most snare drums are gonna have either 8 or 10. Mine has 8. Another element of this drum is gonna be the snare wires right here along the bottom. Basically, those give the drum its characteristic snare sound. Without those wires, there's no way to really distinguish it between a tom or a timbalic. And then finally, the last two elements that we're gonna be discussing in this video are gonna be right here, this little switch. It's a combination of two elements. This top one is going to be called the strainer. Basically, that loosens or tightens the tension of the snares on the bottom based on your desired effect. And then also there is a throw-off switch, and it does exactly just that. It actually throws the snares off of the drum. So whether or not you wanted to turn it into that tom or timbale sound, you would throw the switch off. If you'd want to turn it back into a snare, you would end up turning it right back on. Now that we got the elements out of the way, let's move on to the first step, and that's going to be loosening all of the tension rods until they are completely free of all tension. You're gonna need a drum key for that. You're gonna go ahead and take it. You're gonna turn everything until it's just free and you can just spin it with your fingers. Cool? Okay, now that all of your tension rods are free of any kind of tension, you're gonna go ahead and take your fingers and you're gonna make them all finger tight. You're gonna tighten them until you can't tighten them anymore with just your fingers, okay? Perfect, now that you have everything finger tight, we're gonna go ahead and move on to the next step. You're gonna need a drum key for this. Okay, so the next step is going to be take each tension rod and do one full turn on it. You're gonna wanna go in a star pattern as well. So you're gonna go diagonally and then make it, I'll put up a diagram as far as what the star pattern looks like, so that way you know. Great, now that we have the top with the one full turn on every tension rod, let's go ahead and flip the drum over and we're gonna do the exact same thing. Remember, start with finger tight and then do one full turn on every tension rod inside that star pattern. Okay, perfect. Now that we have both the top and the bottom exactly the same, each tension rod is exactly one turn past finger tight, we're gonna keep working on the bottom head and we're going to go one half turn on every tension rod inside that star pattern. Great, now we're done with the bottom. So let's go ahead and flip the drum back over and we're gonna do the exact same thing to the top. We're gonna go one half turn on the top, each tension rod inside the star pattern. All right, perfect. Let's go ahead and take each tension rod on the top one half turn farther than we already are, and then we should be done with the top. Awesome. Now we're done tuning. So the next step is going to be adjusting the snare wires with the strainer. So right now, everything should be very, very loose. So everything is loose. So you want to loosen that strainer until the snares are not even really putting any tension on the drum, okay? And then the next step is going to be to tighten that strainer until you get just a little bit of tension, okay? So now that you have a little bit of tension, you can hit the top. If you like the way that sounds, you're done. If you don't, and you think, oh, I think it could use a little bit more pop, you can actually tighten that down just a little bit more. Now, me personally, I like a decent amount of tension, so I'm gonna turn it quite a few times. Maybe not that tight, but I want it to be basically that kind of sound right there. And that's my desired approach to tuning a snare. And there you have it.